continues to expand in both military might and political influence.
Soviet Russia holds a commanding position in the future destiny of the world.
But it was the United States that held the secret to atomic power.
Mr. Trump declares we must have atomic power. The flags of freedom fly all over the world.
This superiority would be short-lived, however, as Stalin was already at work on a plan of his own. While searching for uranium on a tiny island off the southeast coast of the Soviet Union, Russian engineers discovered E-99, a powerful and unprecedented source of energy. Seeing an opportunity for further world domination, Stalin authorizes unlimited development funds to explore the capacities of the substance. Viktor Barisov establishes an island research station, Katorga 12. For his groundbreaking research, he receives the Order of Lenin. When Nikita Khrushchev succeeds Stalin, he accelerates the program, pressuring Barisov to begin field experiments. However, not only is E-99 capable of delivering unimagined power, it is also incredibly volatile. Yet Barisov is pressured to begin tests. Disaster has no known survivors. Moscow buries the installation, effectively wiping it from the map. 2010, a US spy satellite flying over the area is blinded by a radiation surge. Fearing another Chernobyl, and suspicious of Moscow's secrecy, the reconnaissance mission over Katorga 12 is ordered by the Pentagon.
All those who have previously registered are free to enter through the North Gate.
This is Devlin 4-1! We were hit, goddammit! I repeat, we were hit! Titan 1 actual here. What's your status, Captain?
It got punched out. Copter's down and we're scattered. Don't know how many KIAs yet. Over.
Satellite's got you about 30 clicks south of a radio tower. Get your team there, Captain. We're pulling you out.
Understood, sir. Spartan team, if you copy, switch your comm gear to TAC-3. Meet up at the rally point.
The influx of new scientists and technicians to Katorga 12 has dwindled to nothing. Rumor has it that Dr. Borisov might become the new head of Katorga 12, but I doubt Moscow has much confidence in him. If only Dr. Demichev hadn't died in the fire. The industrial docks are where supplies are brought in from the mainland. Hundreds of tons of equipment and material are offloaded here every day.
By some miracle, you're alive and hearing this. Rally at the base of the radio tower we passed over before we got bounced. SNR's running carpool from there. Double time it. Move!
Yeah! Someone, save me! My leg is hurt. I can't walk. You'll have to help me.
What happened? What did you do?
What did I do? Nothing. He almost died in there. Fortunately, he saved me.
The influx of new scientists and technicians to Katorga 12 has increased tenfold since Dr. Demichev went to Moscow. His presentation of our work must have been very successful. Additional facilities are being built, and our research funds continue to grow. And to think, only 4 weeks ago, Dr. Demichev almost died in that fire. Whoever saved him did us all a huge favor. I don't know how much time I have, so I'll make this quick. The Singularity exploded about 2 hours ago, killing hundreds of people. But spreading radiation is also having effects. It's mutating humans into violent monsters, and they feed on human flesh. I have to get out of here before they find me.
One actual. Copy. For fuck's sake, someone copy back! Copy back and tell me things look a little south of normal, because I'm officially freaking out! I'm in Section 8 here. I know it, damn it. Okay. Okay, eyes forward. Keep to the original directive. Continue to the radio tower.
should find this recording, please. Our children are hiding in a room at the top of the stairs. They only have a limited amount of food and water and won't be able to last for much longer. Please, they're so scared.
Titan 1, if you're receiving, I'm in what looks like a school, and there's some guy... Holy mother!
Thank you. left us there, all alone. I am hiding in the restroom, and everyone's screaming and panicking outside. I don't know what to do. Please, help!
Are to be alert at all times and remain aware of emergency testing procedures.
Dr. Demichev has told us the equipment they're installing at the school is safe, but I'm worried. I have a friend who works at one of the animal testing labs, and he told me E99 mutates living flesh. How could they expose the children to something like that?
Thank you. both of us. We can't trade with anyone. Not that I feel like eating much. My stomach has been hurting a lot lately.